God has given us a very nice place to, you know, to breed horses. It's a very peaceful environment. The horses look happy, and so the performance also. You know, if a happy horse is a horse, or normally does well.
Come on, hold my hand. I wanna contact the living. Not sure I understand this road I've been given. I sit and talk to God, and He just laughs at my plans. My head speaks a language I don't understand. I just wanna feel real love, feel the home that I live in. 'Cause I got too much life running through my veins, going to waste.
The Mukteshwar Stud Farm is what the multi-classic winner and racing sensation Dutch of Grey calls home.
Scare myself to death. That's why I keep on running.
One of the bravest performances we've seen all year was put in by Siege Courageous on consecutive days at the Invitation Weekend in Calcutta. It's hard to quarrel with victory, and that's exactly where this third generation supported racehorse breeding operation finds itself.
I just wanna feel real love, feel the home that I live in. 'Cause I got too much life running through my veins, going to waste.
So basically, we've grown up around horses. My earliest memories have been of my father playing polo, going to the polo ground and hitting polo balls, running along the field.
So originally, you're all riders from the last 3-4 generations. My father was a rider, I was a rider, my son's a rider, and my granddaughter's a rider. So basically, the riding is in our blood, more or less. So we thought we'd start with this in a small way, and we established a small farm, literally, to summer my polo ponies, basically. And this was actually a planned farm. You know, we knew where to, you know, put our paddocks, where to grow our, and it's contiguous with our agriculture operations. Fresh lucerne is in our backyard.
It's been great. I mean, every tree has been planted personally by everyone here at the farm. The team has been immaculate in terms of planning. We've had close to about almost 1,000 horses go through this place ever since it's been here. Once we moved here, we realized the horses were much, much happier. And I think that's translated a lot into our results. We built a nice team. Everything revolves around the team. You can't win any sort of race, or you can't breed any type of any horse which is of a particular caliber without team effort behind it. You can have all the theories in the world, but until it comes down to practicing them, it's impossible.
In 2009-10, I think, is when we bought Top Class. And he came onto the market quite late. And he himself was a $1.6 million yearling, which Coolmore, you know, bought. So we thought, you know, if you want all the three, you know, points that you look for in a stallion, is confirmation, racing performance, and pedigree.
So Top Class was destined for success, I would say. He was, ever since he was born, he had an immaculate page. He was well received in the market. Coolmore bought him for a very fancy price when he was younger. He's had a consistent run with good performers. If you look at his four-year-old crop, it was destined for success. I mean, they were spectacular looking horses. And now with his babies, there's Dutch of Grey, who's a multiple classic winner.
There's Siege Courageous, who just won Suresh Mahindra over 7 furlongs over the Invitation Weekend in record timing. He now holds 2 track records, one in Bangalore and one in Calcutta. It's quite an achievement.
So he's done everything right for us, and he's now 20, but he's in great shape, and we're looking forward to some more. I feel it's still the beginning for him.
Aye.
So I remember our agent Ajay, and he sent us a video of this horse walking out of the stables, and both me and my father looked at this horse walking out and said, this is who we want.
Dali was, of course, so he seems to be going the right way. And as of now, I think as of today, there are 52 winners by Dali. And he's the leading juvenile sire by double distance.
Since the time I get up to the time I sleep, my niece, my nephew and my daughter, their favorite topic is Dali. Because they hear about Dali so much that every time I enter my room, my daughter says, I want to go to Dali. He's a smashing looking horse. He was bought for a nice price. He was bought, I think, for about $675,000 as a yearling. And he was bought by Coolmore again, so you can't fault his confirmation in any. When we brought Dali, we were looking for a son of Scat Daddy because he had done really, really well. And he's a great source of speed. The interesting thing about Dali is, being by Scat Daddy, he's got a nice female family. His dam sire is Cape Cross, so that infuses stamina. And going back as well, so he's got some nice horses in his page. So it's going to be interesting. His earlier horses have all shown a lot of speed, but I do feel I've been talking to certain trainers that they can go a little further. So time will tell. So let's see, we've got our fingers crossed for him. He's produced some nice horses.
Time and Tide is, I think, his best performer. He won a Group 1 with the Invitation Weekend, the Sprinters' Cup. He's beaten some really, really good horses. So it really is a good indicator of his potential. And the nice thing about Time and Tide is that his dam, Starlet, was actually bred here. She was by Al Johar, who's one of our earliest stallions.
Dali is your champion freshman sire. He was amongst the leading juvenile sires in the country over and above that. So, interesting times. Let's see. Hope we can go strength to strength with him as well. He's got a full book. Top Class has a full book this year. So, let's see how it goes. We bought mares from Goffs and Tattersalls. I went personally to Tattersalls last year. And we bought some nice mares at Goffs this year. The quality of bloodstock that came into India last year, generally speaking, and this year has been exceptional. So we had no option but to sort of up our game and spend that extra dollar and bring some nice mares in.
Over and above the mares that we bought from abroad, we've also been looking at the Indian market for some nice mares. One mare that comes to mind is a mare called Soak. She produced Diff, who won the Stayers Cup over the Invitation Weekend. He just didn't win it, but he also smashed the track record by, I think, 3.5 seconds. That's quite an achievement. She has been mated to Dali, so we're looking forward to some nice runners out of her.
Once you get results, you feel definitely more encouraged, and you feel that, you know, there's a purpose of going forward. And the results are showing, so we are enthused and we are more encouraged to take it forward further.